Hi guys, welcome to another review, and today I'm having another look at one of MEZCO's 112 collective action figures. And today I'm having a look at the regular Batman from Batman v Superman Dawn of Justice. As per usual, we'll start off with the box. You have a very nice plastic slip cover, as this is one of the older ones, so there's no card. You've got the logo, which looks cool. Batman down there, 112 collective there. Then on the top, you've just got Batman v Superman. In the back, you've got like a kind of aged metal effect, which looks cool. On the sides, MEZCO toys, Batman v Superman and the logo. Same deal on the other side. On the top, 112 collective. Bottom, same guff we're used to seeing, you know, their Instagram and whatnot. On the back, this is cool. You get various like kind of posing options. So there's the figure, the logo, the cape and everything. And down here, you've got all of his accessories and stuff, you know, like smoke grenades, the Bat Brander and whatnot. It looks pretty cool. The slip cover comes off, you know, showing you that kind of aged metal effect. I just put the slip cover down on the side, and on the back, it reveals Batman. And this one looks really funny with this logo. It just looks very, I don't know, the logo just looks funny here, like it sticks out too much. Luckily, the figure isn't like that. Magnetized, of course, and in here you've got a very nice glossy bat logo, which also has scratches on it, just like the one on the costume. And here's where all your stuff would be, but I've taken it out for the purpose of the review. Now, before we move on to the action figure, let's take a look at Bats' accessories, which are all here and all look awesome. We'll start off with the hands, as per usual. You get two left and a right hand here, gripping a batarang, which is permanently sculpted in, which is really nice, as you can see there. The batarang looks awesome. More on that when I look at the single batarangs. You've got the gold knuckles, you know, sculpted detail on the inside of the palm there, showing like the stitch lines and everything of the leather. The leather looks like it's been through the mill. If you just look at that, different paint washes and everything. The gloves look like they've kicked some serious ass, you know, the scum of Gotham. Putting that down there. Oop, the batarangs getting a little out of shape. Then here we have two, a left and a right open hands here, as you can see. Same deal with the lovely paint and everything, gold. You get a better look at the inside here with like the seams and the stitch lines and everything for the gloves. That looks really nice. Putting that down. Then here we've got, oh sorry, actually I made a mistake. This actually isn't the open palm hand. This is the open palm hand. This one that I just showed is actually meant for the grappling gun, as you can see. It's meant to be holding a pistol of some sort, so that's cool. Then here we've got the hand design for the Bat Brander with a gap in between the two fingers there. That's cool. You get an interchangeable head with has an angry Ben Affleck look. Looks brilliant, looks just like Ben Affleck. If I zoom in as well, yeah, looks awesome. They've got like a nice glossy paint on the eyes to make them look wet. And with this head, the eyes look like they're looking up, almost like they're looking up at Superman. So I'd rather they be in a kind of straightforward looking position, but yeah, I'm going to use the other head anyway. So that's cool. Then on the topic of other accessories, we get three free batarangs. When I say free, I mean, you know, they're not sculpted into a hand or anything. They look awesome. They have a nice metallic silver sheen with sculpt lines and everything. They're very sharp as well, which is awesome. And what you can do with these is you can take either the right or the left open hand here, and you see the gaps between the fingers? You can actually put said batarangs in between the gaps and create an awesome effect like this. Sorry if that wasn't on camera, but yeah, it's a bit hard to do on camera. But yeah, that looks awesome. You know, it reminds me of the Arkham games, how you can throw three batarangs at three separate goons. That's awesome. It's quite secure as well. As you can see, they stay in pretty well. Yeah, that's really cool. You get the grapple gun, which looks awesome. It actually has like sculpted extra grapples on the side. It's a very nice blackish silver with the brown for the handle, the trigger. looks awesome, and here's where it ports into the back of Batman's belt. That looks very, very nice. And here is where you would put any of these three grapples here. I'll start off with the closed one. As you can see there, you just kind of put it in like so, and there you go. The claws and everything shut, so you know, it's just shot out, so that looks cool. And it makes sense as well, because you know, it shoots out like this, then it'll go through something, then the claws will open. But nevertheless, they gave you this one as well, which looks nice. Oops. A bit hard to do. There we go. And yeah, that looks pretty cool as well. Although it doesn't make sense, I'm glad they gave the option. And finally, we get this one, which is the same, except you've got a string attached to it here. And that just ports in here, like so. So, oops. A lot of accessories with this Batman, so, you know, you feel like you get your money's worth. I'm just going to have to quickly do this off camera. Sorry, guys. But it is quite difficult. There we go. It's quite small, isn't it? So, you know, you get 8 inches of rope, maybe. Looks cool. You get the Bat Brander, as you can see here, which is designed for this hand over here. It doesn't really make sense, in my opinion, as, you know, if he's using this, it should be painted red to give off the effect that it's on. Here we have the button here, and on this side, so I presume, you know, you can just press it with either thumb like that, depending on which hand he's using. But it's a cool accessory, I'm glad they included it. It would be nice if they included two though, you know, one painted red, one not. And then here we have the smoke grenade, which looks alright, you know, it's pretty much blackish silver, not much detail on it. There's a pin, which looks nice, but it's not painted silver or anything, but oh well, cool enough, I guess. Up here we have the typical stand that we're used to, with the logo. Picks up scratches ridiculously easy, and this is the first time I've actually taken it out. I mean, I looked at it, but I haven't used it, as I don't have enough room for these stands, because they're a bit big. But yeah, you know, it's nice. You get this peg here, which can be pushed out from the bottom. I'm able to just do it with my finger, but if you are having a hard time getting it out, I suggest you use the arm, this bottom bit here, just push it out from the bottom. But yeah, you get your typical MEZCO posing arm with 1, 2, 3, 4 points of articulation, as well as a twist here. Oh, it comes off, I didn't know that. Oh yeah, it comes off apparently. And they have redesigned the whole cape feature. Let me just zoom out, and I hate it. I didn't like it on the original Dark Knight Returns one, and I don't like it with this either. You take this, snap it on, and you can bend this. Take any one of these 5 poseable arms, I'll just go for a short one here. Plug it in. You can position it whichever way tickles your fancy, and then you just want to put his cape in here. Although I prefer this, as it's easier to attach the cape, it's still such a hassle. And this is their second attempt at this. I know that they're actually trying it again for the Superman figure. If you saw the interview with Sharpness Prime and Pierre over at Toy Fair, I'd recommend you watch it on Sharpness Prime's channel. They are actually redesigned it again for the Superman. So, you know, maybe third time's the charm. 112 collective bag, as per usual. But I like to leave the accessories in the box. Well, yeah, those are all the accessories, and there are a lot. So let's move on to Batman. Here we go. Here we have the Caped Crusader. And as per usual, let's start off with the head. The head on this guy looks amazing. It looks just like Ben Affleck from all the, well, from this section at least anyway. It's a shame that there's no unmasked head, but oh well. Even if I had an unmasked head, this is the head I'd be using. It comes off very easily. You know, I'll just show you like this. But yeah, you know, the eyes are painted so they're looking straight, which I like. They've got that nice kind of glossy paint on it to make them look wet. And one of the issues I have is here, it looks like the cowl is resting a bit below his chin, which I don't like. There's a little bit of a gap, but oh well. It's not a solid black. There's a little bit of grey mixed in as well, which gives the cowl a very nice effect. Speaking of which, Here's the other head, which can just be put onto Batman like so. If it wants to go on, that is. And yeah, that looks nice. It's a more secure fit than the other one, which is a bit funny, I find. But yeah, I prefer this head. Speaking of the rest of his cowl, I'm not that big of a fan of how they sculpted the cowl like this and left the, well, the shoulder section of the cowl like this and left the actual mask like this. It gives the effect of inconsistency. I would have preferred it if this was also the same similar type of leather sculpt, as it even blends in with the back of the cape, which looks awesome. But oh well, still looks pretty badass. Here we have the logo, which looks very nice. You've got scratches and panel line detailing and everything on it. It doesn't stick out very far either, which is nice, unlike what the promotional image shows on the back of the package. Speaking of panel lines, this figure has all of them going all the way along the suit, as you can see there. It looks very nice. Not too light or not too dark, the lines are. They look just perfect. See, it goes all the way along there. There you've got the stitch line, but it's on the back, so I don't mind. And what I'm really fond of with this figure is the fact that the color just looks amazing. The Hot Toys one looks too dark, the Mattel Multiverse one looks too light. This one and the Mafex ones are the best ones, in my opinion, for color. And this, from what I've seen of reviews, is by far the definitive BVS Batman action figure. But yeah, here we have the gauntlets, you know, with the nice kind of gold and everything. This one's a little bit bent, but it's soft plastic, so I could easily fix it. Here we have the fisted hands, which come on the figure already. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 hands altogether, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8! So that's cool. Same deal here. Nice kind of leather effect going on with some lines on the gloves, which look awesome. The belt looks amazing. I'm just a little bit disappointed that there's no scratch marks on it, but oh well. Looks really cool. I love the design of the belt. It's just a shame there's no scratch marks on it. But it looks cool nonetheless. And along the back, the regular Hot Toys Batman doesn't include this, which is the sculpted, you know, kind of clasp of where the belt clips together, which is really nice. And there you see the port, which is designed for the grapple gun. It's an awkward, like, kind of angle you need to put the gun at to get it to go on. But let's see if I can do it. Okay, I've done it. Oh, no, I have not. Yeah, it's a little bit awkward. But have I got it on? Have I? I've got it. Yeah, it's on. And that looks cool. It's pretty secure. But yeah, I like the fact that you can actually port stuff onto the back of his belt, which is cool. As for the rest of his costume, looks pretty nice. As you can see, his boots, the gold studded caps on the end of his toes, the treads. Yeah, it's awesome. His cape. I've heard a lot of reviewers say they think it's too big. I personally agree with Daredevil19, who says Batman has cape for days. Let's move him all the way back, move the camera back a bit as well. And let's show you the full extent of said cape. That is huge and I love it. You can have it like that if you want, or you can just like kind of fold it up and put it behind him like so. And yeah, it looks fine. And like even the way it like kind of crunches up and everything here, as you can see, it looks really nice. It looks natural. Look like it's almost a sculpted plastic, which looks awesome. And the inside is more of a kind of felty, silky material, which is nice. And on the opposite side, you've got leather. And what's really cool about this, if I just show you the cape here, there's a really nice kind of dirt effect on the back. The camera isn't really picking it up that well, so I'll tell you what I'll do. I will just put a picture, you know, just right about now, showing you what it looks like. So as you can see, that looks awesome. What I like is it's just along the bottom of the cape, whereas with the Hot Toys one, it comes up to about here, which is just far too much in my opinion. It should be more subtle, and this one nails it. Now then, the articulation. You get a ball joint in the head, which looks really nice, and you know, you can get some good movement out of it. Comes off a little bit easily, but oh well. You've got butterfly joints in the arm, which come out. They go back further than they do come out. They go up and down as well, which is awesome. You can swivel at the arm, you know, it's not very restrictive at all, this material, which is awesome. Double hinged elbows, which is cool, you know, you can punch himself in the face. But of course it's Batman, so he's not going to do that. He's going to punch you in the face. You've got a swivel at the top of the glove, as well as a swivel and a hinge at the wrist, which looks really cool. You get a, what do you want to call this, abdomen joints, because it has to be down here to be an ab crunch. But yeah, it works pretty well, as you can see. The only problem I find is that I don't want to do it as this kind of pulps into the fabric, the very bottom of the bat. So, you know, just be careful, I'd say. You can twist it there as well. That's nice. I don't think he has a waist swivel. Or does he? No, he doesn't have an ab crunch, and I don't think he has a waist swivel either. It's a bit hard to tell with these figures. His legs can kick out, which looks awesome. And does he have a swivel at the top of the thigh? No, I think he just swivels at the leg. Once again, really hard to tell. Double hinged knees, which look awesome. You can swivel at the top of the boots. He has hinged feet, which move out really nice, as well as ankle pivot, which is pretty cool. So yeah, this figure is just awesome. I absolutely love it. I didn't actually pay for this. I was lucky enough to actually be gifted this by a family member. So even though I'm short on funds, I have a new MEZCO to review for you, and I'm really happy about that. He looks awesome. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to kind of put him in the position that I like him to be in. And yeah, talk a little bit in the process. I know many people weren't that fond of the film, but, you know, my suggestion is watch the Ultimate Edition. It's a lot cooler, and it helps explain more of the film if you got at all confused. It's just really good. I love the effects, the designs, the universe that DC are creating for their cinematic universe. It looks awesome. I can't wait to see what else they're going to do with it. I think it's just going to be awesome. I personally, although I love Marvel, I prefer DC. It's just me and, you know, just my preference personally. But yeah, I enjoy both Marvel and DC, but DC has my heart for life. I think it was an awesome film. I particularly love how they did Batman, you know, like with his grapple gun in that scene where he saves Martha. And, you know, he shoots it through a guy's shoulder. You can see it come out the other end. And then he, like, kind of flings him. And that's awesome. Even with the batarangs, you know, he uses them. Because, you know, I played, like, the Arkham games and stuff. And, you know, if you end a combo with a batarang, he throws it. And he just hits them in the head and knocks them down. And I kind of think to myself, hang on. If anything, shouldn't it kind of, like, go through their head? But in this universe, don't worry, they do. They do some serious damage, and I love it. That's one of the things quite a lot of people like kind of criticized about the film, the whole Martha aspect. But I put this to you. Why is Batman Batman? He doesn't want what happened to him as a child to happen to anyone else. This is why he dons the mantle of the Bat, to save people. And, you know, the fact that he stopped, you know, because he was going to kill Superman. Because he's Batman. Even Superman can't compare to him. Batman is God. Yep, little rant over. He saves Martha. It's what he does. I don't understand why some people get fixated on it. Like that Marvel comic. It was, what was it called? There was, inside the comic, there was another comic. And it was called Dawn of Boredom. Both of their mothers are named Martha. You won't believe it. Not very subtle dig at the film. But I loved it. The concept that this is how they become friends. As they are best friends, and yeah, nothing wrong with that. But yeah, little rant about the film to the side. This is a badass action figure. I believe it's the definitive Batfleck. If you want to get one, I'd highly recommend you go for the armored Batman as well. That looks fantastic. It's actually diecast, which looks cool. But it's, you know, a con exclusive, so it's expensive, and I don't think I'm going to be getting it anytime soon. But yeah, if you're interested at all, this was £85 from the Birmingham Forbidden Planet. I like it. I didn't pay for it, but I think it's worth the £85 as it comes with so many accessories. I think if MEZCO prices are just going to keep on going up and up like they have, like I remember my MEZCO cap was about £65, this is 20 more. I think between 80 and 85 is reasonable. Leave it at that price, MEZCO. Otherwise, people won't be able to buy them. And yeah, I think 85 is reasonable for this. So leave it at that, MEZCO, please. Pretty please. I really love your line. And yeah, what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to show you what he looks like amongst all my other MEZCOs. So bear with me, guys. Okay then, so here we have my MEZCO BVS Batfleck amongst all my other MEZCOs, as you can see here. Oop, bit of dust just flew by the camera. He looks cool, I like him in that position. Here are my other three Batmans. Mutant Leader, Cap, and two Judge Dreads, and the Lawmaster. Speaking of this guy right here, the esteemed gentleman holding the shield, they had him in the Birmingham Forbidden Planet as well. You know how much? I shit you not, $94.99 or $93.99, one of those two prices. £90? That is just ridiculous. Out of the bloody world that price is. I mean, £94? I got him as a Christmas gift and it was 65-ish. And I think that is just extortion at that price. But yeah. I just wanted to show you what he looks like. There he is with his grapple gun. Like I mentioned in my review, I love that scene with the grapple as he shoots it through a goon's shoulder. So that's why I've got him with the grapple. His cape is nicely tucked behind and it looks cool. Similar with these guys, the cape is huge, but you know, it's tucked behind. There's my favorite one up there. My favorite MEZCO 112 that guy is. I will get the Punisher eventually. And I know that figure will become the best MEZCO I own. However, that guy right there will still be my favourite. So yeah, they all look really nice together. Anyway, that's my review, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll try and get a few more reviews out next week. Thanks for watching, guys. Take care.